Hey everyone, this is a three-part video about using your MacBook with the Flipper Zero. I'll try to release a new video every couple of days, so please click the subscribe and the bell notification. This video is part one, where I'll show how to set up your Mac for Flipper Zero development. I have videos in my code playlist if you're running on a different OS. In part two, I'll show how to clone, build, and install custom applications. This is helpful if you want to run an application that's not on lab.flipper.net, or if you want to modify an application that is on lab.flipper.net. And then finally, in part three, we'll add new features to the Lab 401 Lite Messenger app that I talked about a few weeks ago. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is open the App Store and then click the Develop tab. In Develop, scroll down and you'll find Xcode. The button will either say Get or Open. Go ahead and click that. The pop-up window should appear. Make sure that Mac OS 16 is checked. And then I also checked Predictive Code, but this is an optional step. Go ahead and click Download and Install. I'll go ahead and type in my password, and then once I've typed in my password, I'll click Install Software. And if this is your first time doing this, it may take a few minutes. Go ahead and click on the Continue button. Xcode will install some tools such as Python 3 and Get, which we'll use later in this video. It looks like everything's installed, so I'll go ahead and go to Xcode and quit Xcode. And then I'll also go ahead and close the App Store. Next, we'll open a web browser and we'll go to code.visualstudio.com. And then we'll click on Download for Mac OS. That'll take a moment to download. And then once it's downloaded, we'll go ahead and click on it and open the zip file. And then we'll open Visual Studio Code application. We'll click on Open to the confirmation. And now we have Visual Studio Code running. To allow us to invoke Visual Studio Code from a terminal window, we'll go to View and then Command Palette. And then we'll type Shell Command Install Code Command in Path. Click OK to the administrator box. Then type in your password and then click the OK button to confirm your password. And hopefully code will now be successfully installed. Now that Visual Studio Code's installed, we can go ahead and quit Visual Studio Code, and then we can close those extra windows as well. Next, open a web browser to github.com, Jameson Derrick, Flipper Zero Tutorials, Wiki. Scroll down on the pages to the Install Firmware and Apps choice. And then choose step 3, recursively clone the firmware you want to use. We'll be using Visual Studio Code to clone our firmware. However, the URLs we want to use are the same. Pick the firmware you want to run on your Flipper Zero. I'll choose official firmware. So that's this first URL. Copy the URL to the clipboard, and then in a new tab, go ahead and paste in that URL. Another way to get that URL is on the GitHub. Go ahead and click on code, and then click on this copy to clipboard link. I'll press Command Space to bring up Spotlight Search, and then we'll type in code and click on Visual Studio Code. Next, we want to recursively clone our Flipper Zero firmware. So we'll go to View and then Command Palette, and we'll type in Git clone and then choose the recursive option. Go ahead and paste in that GitHub repository for whichever firmware you've chosen, and then choose clone from URL. Next, we need to choose a location to store our repos. I'll go ahead and click new folder in repo, but leave a comment if there's a best practice as to where we should be storing our repos. And finally, I'll choose select as repository destination. And this will take a few minutes while it downloads everything from the internet. I'll go ahead and speed up this part of the video. And now we can go ahead and click on Open to open the cloned repository. I'll choose yes for get fetch, and this will just make it so that our Visual Studio grabs the latest firmware on occasion. Next, I'll open the .vs code folder, and then in the menu, we'll choose terminal and then new terminal. In the terminal, we'll type /fbt space VS Code underscore dist and press return. This will make it so that our firmware supports Visual Studio Code. In the .vs code folder, you should see those files get installed. And at the same time, we're also installing the toolchain. So all the tools needed to build the firmware are part of this package. I just realized some of the text may be hard to read in the video, so I'll go ahead and do a zoom in so that we can see the text a little bit easier. Apologize for that. And now that we've installed those files for our VS Code environment, I'll go ahead and go to Code and then quit Visual Studio Code. I'll go ahead and do Control Space for Spotlight Search, type in Code, and then click on Visual Studio Code. This time you should get a pop-up about recommended extensions. Please click on Install to install the recommended extensions, and then I'll say Trust Publishers and Install. There's probably some best security practice about looking at each extension and make sure that the number of people that have downloaded it and everything else seems reputable. We'll go ahead and close those extension windows. This one had 90,000, 127, 253, 1 million, 1.6 million, 2.5 million, and 4.5 million. So luckily those were probably extensions I could trust. We'll go to Terminal and then we'll choose Run Task. This should now populate with all the different Flipper Zero options, and we'll go to Release Flash USB with Resources. Make sure that your Flipper Zero is plugged into your computer and that QFlipper is not running. I'll go ahead and change this part of the video to 800 speed. Even at 800 speed, this takes quite a while it compiles all of the Flipper firmware. And then once it's done compiling, it'll transfer those files to our Flipper Zero, and then it'll initiate an install on the Flipper Zero. It just finished copying. I'll change this part to 200 speed. And now you can see on the Flipper Zero screen that it's updating the firmware to the latest official firmware that we've built. We didn't choose a branch, so we're actually building the dev branch. The dev branch has all the latest features. However, it hasn't gone through the same level of testing as a release branch, so you may hit a few bugs. Also, if you're running one of the custom firmwares like RogueMaster, it includes a lot of applications that get pre-installed, and so those applications will take extra time for the updating process to finish. Looks like we're on our final reboot. Over on the computer, go ahead and click Allow for the USB accessory to be able to connect to the Mac, and then we should be able to open QFlipper. And there it is, our firmware update success. Congratulations, your Flipper is now running firmware that you custom built. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. In a couple days, we'll take a look at how to compile and install custom applications on your Flipper Zero. If you have any questions about this video, please leave a comment below or contact me on Discord.